Hi, all the friends from the Computex world. It's a pleasure to be here. My name is Jack Chen. I'm your host today. I'm going to introduce the MIH as a whole. I'm the CEO of MIH Alliance. Since last year, we have kicked off this initiative with a group of people. Of particular note, there is a lot of industrial supporter of this MIH Alliance. So let me give you more detail about it. First of all, I would like to introduce myself. I'm a veteran for the automotive industry for the last 40 years. And for the experience that I have, I've been always working in mainstream and traditional OEM, for instance, Ford and FCA. And my background also, I'm on the supply chain and engineering and industrialization of the products. However, since 5-6 years ago, I have embarked with a new initiative in EV, which is called NIO as a startup. I was one of the co-founders of NIO, and there has been up and down with NIO, but I would like to also give you some background of the EV world in this part of the world. I have been and engineering as a start, as I say. But with all this, the branding and also the initiative of the supply chain become so important for the recent days. So let me give you a very, very high level rundown of MIH. The MIH actually was kicked off by Foxconn Group last October in their Tech Day. And the MIH, as a platform, stands for minimalization, innovation, and harmony. Meaning, it's a very simple platform, and is so much integrated and harmonized into a skateboard. And that skateboard can put variation of top hats, and also the hardware and software stacks on it. For instance, so far, our partnership started from Foxtron. If you can see the slides, Foxtron is a joint venture between Foxconn and the Yulon Group. It has been a hardware provider associated with also partially some of the software. MIH is constituted of all this MIH hardware and software together. So, if you look at the current day, the supply chain has been involved into all kinds of tiers. Tier 1, Tier 2, Tier 3, Tier 4, you name it, they have it. But since the last November, there have been a lot of issues in the supply chain, particularly on the chips, the semiconductors. All this issue really becoming more and more exacerbated because of the tier 1 to tier 4 kind of layer becoming a barrier for that. A lot of people say, well, where is the chips manufactured by the tier 1? And the tier 1 have to go to the tier 2, tier 3, tier 4 to find out where the location is. Until they find out the issue, there has been a time lag and make a complication of the supply capacity. So our idea is to put MIH with current membership and everybody in the components, in the services of the cloud, the telecommunication company, the IT supplier, and also tier one traditional supplier, all bundled together and put it a very flat supplier tiers. So we will be able to see the transparency and also make sure the tier one to tier four of communication being faster and more efficient. So with that, I would like to give you a background of the PC computers and smartphone and then evolve into the smart EV. As you in the computer world, you know better than I do that a PC basically evolve into a smartphone. The smartphone has the capability and capacity of managing all the algorithm 10 or 20 years ago, much faster and smaller. But having said that, I think there is a trend of putting everything on a motherboard and commonize it and try to reduce the cost and make sure that the time to market is also faster. So if you look at the EVs right now, everybody is talking about smart mobility. That's where MIH is cutting in. With all the reporting for the last several months, I know there's been people telling people about the Foxconn, the EV world, and a lot of issue is being tackled and technology being evolved into a higher level of status. But having said that, I think from the media side, I would like to give you more elaboration of what's going on, because sometimes there are pieces that you have to pick up the pieces anyway. So having the whole supply chain coming into this ball game. So far, I think the 1,500 members registered since October, the ramping up was so quickly, particularly this year in the early stage, we have a very steep rising in terms of our membership. In fact, as of yesterday, it's almost 1,600 already. So why is that? People are longing for the open platform. And that's something that a lot of closed loop not doing. So we would like to give you an insight on how the 1,500 or 1,600 supply partner will be able to deliver. I think the most important thing, if you can see this is on the funnel itself is really try to do an arrangement, an organization of the best of the best, who can supply to the key solution and modularity rather than just a component. You know, the component's profit margin is much lower than the modularity. As you can see, now globally, for most of the big player, they are modularity supplier or the key solutions provider, not components. And that will help and also put them into the market front to go to market. So this is the funnel thing. And as a MIH group, we are doing that. So we're not just only a small consortium, we are actually a group of people and supply chain and partnership and an industrial partner to be able to go to market together. This chart gives you a very good illustration of the horizontal below and horizontal above. Horizontal below is the alliance members, started from automotive industry supplier, the ICT component players, the electrification player, and eventually we have include the software developer and the cloud connectivities providers. Now, actually, you see, well, are you gonna take care of everything? I think we are trying our best to put everybody together on an open platform. So the legacy of like the industry-wise, everybody trying to be a closed loop, not to open up their specification and outlet to others. Actually, to make that clarity and make sure the development timing and the efficiency of the cost being there. And above the horizontal line, you can see this is the outlets. These are the potential customers we're working on to make sure that we will capture the marketplace and give them the best solution, a common platform, a scalable, and also a differentiation of the body style and product specification, eventually the software stack to support all these go-to-market customers. So, having said that, just put it very simple. For the next 2 years, what are we gonna do? The upcoming event in July and also all the way through the later part of this year, we'll be able to give you an upcoming event to illustrate what we're going to do. And also, we will provide an e-bus starting from the public transportation to make sure that e-bus is available to all the publics, starting from Taiwan, and we'll replicate in the other market. And then the C-segment car in 2023. The platform, as you can see, is very simple, it's scalable, it's got all the goodies, and you've got a whole nine yard that people will be able to develop on that. And the platform itself consists of software and hardware. And the platform also gonna create an ecosystem to be able to manage that customer's interface. So I will give you a rundown on how the business model is going. When the alliance is formed, the alliance will be able to provide to different customers different requirements. You can start it from 50% of a skateboard only, or you can do an 80% skateboard plus the body style and leave the user experience to the customer, their own development. Or, the last but not the least, 100%, just like Muji, and you manage to the market's need, 100%, except the logo. So the branding will be managed by our customer, but everything else, we manage that. This is the beautiful car. And as you can see, 2023, we're gonna launch this car. Also started with different customer. We have 4 or 5 customer now are looking at this and we're working on it. So all this is gonna be, including the e-bus, will be our first couple of product, and we are having other product to come into. The last, the software, and also the open platform. The spirit of open platform is so important to the industry. If you can see the EV stack with all the RTOS, the real-time things, and the mission critical will be developed here. On top of that, we'll put the non-mission critical, the IVI, all the other user-engaged kits together on this platform. So the right-hand side, you can see the hardware, and the left-hand side with the software, and link up with the cloud. This is probably the best description of how the open system looks like. To the right-hand side is the MIH plus the reference design, the 50, the 80, or 100% that I just mentioned. They can put on top of the MIH EV kits with all the reference design. Compared to the phone industry, the top part of it is actually the design like Pixel, the phone that Google developed. But on the lower end is a free open system of Android. So MIH is more like Android of the EV. So we can put on top of it with a lot of reference design. The last, really circle around the MIH EV kit, we can take care of the vehicle's computer units and also the body control and the battery management system, and so on. All this will be centering on it, so we'll be able to get all this done with the EV kits. And this is the MIH mission and vision. So the last, I would like to thank you for participating in this event, and it's my pleasure to do all this summary for you. I'll be happy to take, in the future, another chance to talk to you guys. Thank you very much.